which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Page 575, Sandra.
Okay.
Truly missed. We miss them not being here. Good to have Lee and Jackie here visiting with us today to grace our church with your presence. Good to have you here. As we go to prayer requests this morning, I'd like to start off as always with praising our Lord and Savior. for all that he does for us, and always on standby when you need. So he deserves our prayer, and I give to him gladly. I ask you to continue to pray for Herman Rhodes. Keep him in your prayers. Ask you to be with Doug. He needs our desperate prayers desperately. He's got infection in his knee, and surgery may be in the forecast for the future, but we don't know just yet. But be a much prayer for him. If he had to go back in this time, it'd be the fourth time. So be a much prayer. Keep him lifted up. Also, Carolyn Arson and Tim, keep giving your prayers. Sister Ruth, good to have her back with us again. Pray for Brother Mike, and as also Brother Matthew, keep giving your prayers. Kim Glover's not with us today, but be keep her in your prayers. Remember our church and all churches that we all may get together, come together as one body, one unit in Christ, that will be a force for this nation to be reckoned with. Right now, our churches are just dangling around, and attendance is falling off. They're not growing. It just bothers me to see you get 40,000 people to go to a stadium and watch a ball game. You can't get four people to come to church. Mm-hmm. There's something seriously wrong with this picture. Amen. Pray for our churches, and they all find Christ before it's too late. I ask you once again, it's an election year. I remind you of that. Please get out and vote. Go to prayer. Lord gracious Heavenly Father, once again I stand before you, Heavenly Father, Lord. You heard the names of your children in your church here today, Heavenly Father, Lord. The names mentioned here today, Heavenly Father, Lord. The needs, petitions, and concerns associated with each name, Heavenly Father, Lord. Lord, I don't despair, Heavenly Father, Lord. And I take this opportunity to lift them up to you this hour, Heavenly Father, Lord. Pray that your healing hand, love, and mercy be upon them, Heavenly Father, Lord. Healing their bodies of the sickness and affliction, Heavenly Father, Lord. As your ministers guide us to the lost and misguided souls, Heavenly Father, Lord. Guide us to those that's got decisions that's got to be made, Heavenly Father, Lord. And it's weighing heavy on their heart and mind and not sure about which way to go, Heavenly Father, Lord. Along with that guidance, Heavenly Father, a minister of wisdom, Heavenly Father, Lord. And Lord, your children are carrying so many burdens on their shoulders right now, Heavenly Father, Lord, trying to handle things themselves, Heavenly Father, Lord. Lord, I'm not despairing, Heavenly Father, Lord, but I know that you have the answer, Heavenly Father. You have the solution to their problems. All they have to do is find the strength and the courage, Heavenly Father, to come forward, Heavenly Father, Lord, and lay their problems at the foot of the cross, Heavenly Father, Lord. Lord, we give you all the praise and all the glory, Heavenly Father, Lord. And we thank you, Heavenly Father, for being ever ready, Heavenly Father, Lord, in our time of need and stress. Distress, grief, and sorrow. I ask you to comfort those that lost loved ones, Heavenly Father, Lord. Comfort their heart, Heavenly Father, Lord, this hour. Lord, we ask you to accept our love for you, Heavenly Father. We thank you for loving us. For these things we do, ask in your holy and precious name, Heavenly Father, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
At this time, we'll come to the part of the service where we take up our tithes and offerings. If our usher will come forward and take up the offering.
Good morning. So when I was asked to do the special song of praying, I was like, Lord, what song should I sing? You know, I don't want to just mumble words. I want it to be meaningful. I want it to touch somebody. And of course, my favorite song, I Surrender All, came to my mind. Before I sing, I just want to say that there are three barriers that block totally surrendering to God. Fear, pride, and confusion. So right now, I just want to pray against any fear, against any pride, and against any confusion. We rebuke you in the name of Jesus. We cast it down. We render confusion, fear, and pride powerless against the people in this congregation. And we release it from its assignment. And Lord, we want to be where you are. So I surrender all of me to you.
Thank you.
Amen.
Take me to the King. That should be all of our heart's desire. Take me to the King. I have gifts to give you. You lay them at his feet. And you just want to lay in his presence. I love that song. I don't sing it like the person who wrote it, but I do think that God wants to move in his spirit in each and every one of us he touches. To let us know where our loved ones are, you know, to heal our bodies. And just allow God to move in each and every one of your hearts. Thank you.
We need to keep praising the Lord, even in our times of sorrow and our times of grief, because he is worthy to be praised, and he is our mighty God. Let's stand together and sing, "Mighty is our God."
Mighty is our God.
Mighty is our King. Mighty is our Lord.
Our God, mighty is
Spirit works things out. Because the song you sang, and that's one of my favorite hymns, by the way, and when you read the story behind it, if I exactly remember it, I tell it to you, it's absolutely this side of amazing. God's presence, even in the darkest of hours, He's there. As much as I remember, a man lost his wife and some children in a shipwreck, and as he passed by the exact same place going back, I think, to England, grieving as anybody would, these words, "It as well came to a soul." And it's so great to serve a Savior that loves us, even when we deserve a nod on our head, which I do regularly. He loves us through it all. I have a lot of things that I worry about in this life. One thing I never have to worry about is whether or not Jesus is with me. Because He promised He would never leave me nor forsake me. And I know you're not supposed to worry, but anybody says they don't slide. So let's go ahead and confess while we're here. I have watched, just this past week alone, things I really just cannot wrap my mind around. And this is going to actually be a very uplifting message. It's going to show exactly what she was singing about. The title of this message is called Resting in the Presence of the Lord. Amen. That's the kind of hard thing to do sometimes, especially in the time we live in when it seems like we are bombarded by so much negativity and literally satanic influence in the world we're in. I heard a completely disturbing statistic this week. Now, mind you, I understand that marriage and family is not for everybody, but did you know that the Gen Zers, the youngest ones, 20s, only 47% plan to get married and have families? Think about that. Far cry from when most of us were young and went to grandma's house, and there's about a 100 of them over there. You know, I mean, cousins galore, and the whole focus was on the family, and that was such a big deal, and it just seems like we're watching everything that was said would happen. And one of the things it says, people would be without natural affection. When you hear of kids going missing and things like that, people are lacking affection, godly affection. Why? Because Jesus is coming. Amen. I'm going to preach that till the day I either die or He calls me out of here on the rapture. I take your pick, but I'm heading out one way or the other, and I know where my destination is. But there are them times in life, and by the way, I just want y'all to know, I've told you this before, but I want to reiterate, when you tell me something that you're going through, I'm carrying it with me. I'm sitting there praying about it at my house for the Lord to intercede on your behalf. Me and the Lord have some long, lengthy conversations about each of you. I've talked about each of you. Just because I don't always, and I've tried to be better about my phone call, although as of late I have not been on top of as great as I'd like to be or visiting, but when I do, I am concerned about you. But I was thinking about this, and I'm going to throw a little confession here, and then we're going to get into the Word. By the way, you'll be finding the text this morning. We're going to be starting in Psalms. Yeah, this is the second message out of Psalms in a couple of weeks. Guess which book I've been in my nose deep in lately? Psalms chapter 4. While you're looking that up, most of you who know me know that before God called me into the ministry of pastoralship, I was a truck driver. And for 20 years, I zigzagged this entire country. I have seen it go from anywhere from about 35 below zero to 120 in the Mojave Desert. I've been in every kind of weather and traffic situation you can imagine. But the one thing that I had when I was in that truck, and sometimes weeks on end right by myself, was something I used to do with Jesus. It was like he was riding shotgun with me. And I'd sit there and just talk to him, just like I would you. Mm-hmm. Just that loving fellowship. And this rude awakening, you know, the Holy Spirit has a way of getting your attention sometimes. And this week, the Holy Spirit spoke in my heart and says, I love all that praying, but I miss the fellowship. Yeah. And all of a sudden, I was like, oh, wow. I'm doing a lot of praying, but he just wants to spend some time with me. How amazing is it that the God of heaven and earth wants to spend time with you and with me? That is a phenomenal thing. But there are times we all get weary. I imagine most of us in here are. I know most of, most of y'all is at least the outside story. I think most everybody in here is going through something, whether it's health, family, body. This world's rough. That's good old effects of sin. But you know what? I'm so glad I have a Savior. Amen. And it's during them hours that I feel like I can't go on. Jesus is saying, come unto me, all you who are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. You're not going to find rest in the world. Like I said, just this past week, I watched in an American city. If you hadn't known better, you would have thought it was Afghanistan. As these guys with machine guns and guns broke down some apartment doors from Venezuela and broke in and literally ran the tenants off and overtook the buildings. Folks, they don't want the, they'll let any book, including some of the most vile stuff you could ever imagine, into our schools, but they will absolutely have a canary if you put a Bible in there. Amen. Whatever way this election goes, I'm going to tell you, the best we got is about 4 more years. We better start praying for revival to hit the land. And revival ain't going to hit the land until revival hits the church. Amen. It's not going to start out there, friends. If you're waiting for it to happen down the road, you might as well go on home. But I want it to start right here with me. I am the righteousness of God in Christ. I will not fear what the devil may bring me because I am a servant of God. It's time to start standing on the promises instead of sitting on the premises. Told me to Psalm 4, and we're going to start in verse 6. Now, to give you a little backdrop on this, David writes the psalm. He has a pretty good idea of what a dysfunctional family looks like. Okay. He's on exile at this point when he's writing this. His son Absalom has tried to take his throne and have him killed. Now, how'd you like to have a kid that? Was like that. But he wanted him out. And by the way, his top advisor was the one that snookered him into doing it. I can't say his name, so I ain't going to try, because I ain't going to have y'all laughing at me. You know I can't speak some of these big names. But David is talking to the Lord, and I really think he gives us a great outline to work with here. So no matter where you're at, God can touch you. Listen to this, verse 6. There be many who say, who will show us any good? Lord, lift you up the light of your countenance upon us. You have put gladness in my heart. More than in the time that their corn and their wine increased. I will both lay me down in peace and sleep. There it is. For you, Lord, only make me dwell in safety. Amen. Friends, first thing you need to know, safety is of the Lord. Amen. Yeah. There is nothing in this world that has insurance policy on it. The only insurance policy you'll ever have is the blood of Jesus Christ shed on Calvary's Hill. That's the only insurance policy you've got, and it's the only one you need. It was enough when he cried to Telestai. It is finished, paid in full from the cross. It was enough. It was done. It was settled.
That's right, amen.
You may feel like you're out on a plank and there's sharks hovering below you. My dear friends, God is there. God is the master of the wind and the waves. As I've said before, I don't care how high the waves ever get over your head, they're still under his feet.
Yeah,
we need to be looking up, not looking out. First verse, verse 6. He's looking for the saint. Listen to what he says. Lord, lift you up the light of your countenance upon us. Well, guess what? A lost person ain't got no light in them. We need to be, as Jesus said, letting our light shine.
Amen.
Why do we look like oddballs in this world? Because we are. A peculiar nation, as they're sometimes called. Why? Because there's darkness on every hand, and we're a light, and darkness hates the light.
Amen.
We shouldn't be walking with the world. We should be walking completely against the world. And too often times, and this is why the church is sick right now, you got too many trying to live like the world on Monday through Saturday and then come in like they're white as doves on Sunday morning.
Yeah.
Either in or you're out. I'm getting a little tired of this fence hopping. I see a lot of places going on, a lot of people. They think they got it all good. Well, I got to tell you, I don't ever take anything for granted. I thank Jesus Christ for his blood every day, and I ask for his mercies fresh and anew. I want a fresh and new anointing every day. Why? Because he has an unlimited supply, and he just wants to give it away. He wants to give the good things to his children. That's hard to see when you're down and out. What the enemy has done is he has used everything he can to bring you down. And I'm telling you what, if he's doing as much as he's doing against you, Marvin and Sherry, and I'm telling you right now before you leave, I'm pulling you up here, we're going to anoint you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We're going to claim power over these demonic things that are coming against you guys. But I'm telling you what, victory is on the way.
Yeah.
Amen. Enemy is a liar. He is the father of all lies, and it's about time the church stand up and let the redeemed say so.
Yeah.
My goodness.
Yeah, yeah.
I must have got deep. I forgot to take decaf this
morning. Amen. Praise God.
But we look to verse 7. You have put gladness in my heart. How many of you are glad even when you're sad? Oh, I felt some days till I wanted to cry, but inside that very deepest part of me, there's that hope and that peace that passes all understanding that says, Mike, you're going to make it. There's not a demon in hell that can beat me because I beat them all at the cross.
That's right. That's right.
Hang on. Yeah. Hang on. Victory's on the way.
Ooh, yeah.
Don't you back up. Don't you give up. Start looking up,
yeah.
Praising up, rejoicing.
Yes, right.
Jesus has come.
Mm.
More than in the time, verse 7, than in the time that their corn, now there, anytime you see there in the Bible, he's talking about lost folk. Capisce, that's true in the Old Testament or in the New Testament. We're the sheep, they're the goats.
Yeah.
Get it? That's kind of a nice short sermon. Thank you, amen. We have gladness, but we have a gladness that is not based on material wealth.
Yeah.
It's not based on the things of this world. We have blessings that are out of this world.
Mm-hmm.
Along with what I like to call, I used to see that bumper sticker and loved it. We've got a retirement plan that's out of this world.
Yeah.
Man, that's good stuff, ain't it, Brother Sandy?
Uh-huh.
Woo! I can't wait. But you see, the people today, and here's where we need to pray for the lost. Seriously, we must pray. We must witness. Their time is running out. And I'm going to tell you how God revisits things. You know, I mentioned to you what just happened in Colorado. Think about three of the most nutty states in the union. Of course, we've got quite a few of them now, but I'm going to use a few of them you'd know about just because it's starting to become an issue again. In 1996, California was the first state to legalize medical marijuana.
Yeah.
Then in 2012, Washington and Colorado were the first states to legalize recreational marijuana. Where do you see a lot of the craziness in this country going? California? Washington a few years ago? Remember they set up the CHOP zone? Nobody, no rules, no laws. Boy, they're very glad I wasn't good, right? I had the whole doggone guard down there. They'd been gone faster than you. What happened? Folks, we are turning away from God as a nation, but as a church. I'm concerned with the church. I can't do nothing. We are not going to ever get true change in this nation unless we get true change in the church. Because I hate to tell y'all the truth, but our society is a reflection of the church. And unfortunately, the church has become a strong reflection of society in many. Not all. There's some great ones out there. But many churches today, you see them absolutely abandoning church dogma to make people feel good. Or you don't want to offend anybody. Well, guess what? I'm going to offend you. And I don't care.
Right.
If I saw you about to walk over a cliff that was going to drop 2,000 feet and you were going to die, wouldn't you want me to tell you, hey, you might not want to take the next step?
Amen. That's right.
I'm sick of these gutless cowards plagiarizing pastors that don't have enough nerve to tell their congregation they need to repent and get right before God.
Right.
Bunch of cowards. I tell them to the face.
Yeah.
Once again, we are called to be the light of the world. We must stand out against the darkness of this present age. If it feels like there's more demonic attacks, you're not crazy. You're not losing your mind. It's real. Why is it real? Because Jesus said it was going to happen at the end of days.
Amen.
What you're seeing now is what happens when the light starts to diminish and the darkness comes to take over. But I'm going to tell you one thing, it can't take over. It can't take over the light in you. If you're a born-again believer, He cannot beat you.
Amen.
Stand firm on the Word of God. Rest with the saints. Verse, second portion is the seven, is spiritual blessings. We need to be focusing not. He deals with the saint and he talks about the importance of spiritual blessings. Once again, that goes back to we need to talk to the Lord. Do y'all understand what I'm saying by that? Not just good morning, poor. I'm not saying take away from your prayer time, but just say you're sitting in your vehicle driving down the road. Lord, I'm having a rough time. You ain't gonna lie to him, he already knows. If you think you're gonna fool him, good luck. So you might as well tell them whether it's good, bad, or indifferent. If you got any sin, Lord, I did it. I'm sorry. I repent. I'm turning. Help me. Help me. Help me.
Amen. Yes.
That's probably been my greatest refrain to God that I've ever had is help me. Help me, Jesus.
Yeah.
I'm a hot mess here. Get you some help from God by talking to Him like a friend. Just tell them how it is. Don't try to dress it up in pretty words. Tell them what your heart is. He's listening. He's able. He's willing. He's desiring. And finally, verse 8 says, we could sleep in the Lord. Now remember, David is writing this against the backdrop of running away from his own son, who's trying to kill him and overtake his throne. By the way, God will straighten that one out.
Yeah.
But it didn't happen overnight, did it? Most things in our lives, as I'm preaching to the choir now, know that God doesn't work on our timetable. Because if he did, how much faith would that take? If we knew what tomorrow brought, wouldn't require faith, would it? We need to walk by faith and what? Not by sight. Y'all need to get that in your spirit. It's going to help you. Say it with me. I'm going to walk by faith and not by sight. Y'all still ain't convinced me, but say it. I'm going to walk by faith and not by sight. I will trust in the Lord. I don't care what's going on around me. I'm going to keep my focus straight ahead on Him.
Yeah, that's right.
We can say it as well with our soul, even when our soul is hurting. We can talk to Jesus as our dearest friend. Someone we can tell, Lord, my heart is grieving. He knows it, but He just wants to hear it from you. Why? Because He loves you that much.
Amen.
Yeah, that's right.
Man, we sell Him short. He loves you beyond measure. He loved you when you couldn't stand Him. It says, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Yeah, that's right.
What a mighty God we serve.
Amen.
Woo! That's good news. That'll get you happy. What a mighty God we serve.
Yeah.
We need to start breaking down the strongholds. We need to start coming against the devil where we see him. We need to rise up. This is the church's greatest hour right before she's called out to meet the Lord in the clouds. We can be a powerful force for the kingdom of God if we'll simply put our trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. Walking by faith and not by sight. So even in this point where David is so burdened by dysfunctional family issues, he says, I will both lay me down in peace and sleep. For you, Lord, only make me dwell in safety.
Yeah.
Isn't that beautiful?
Ooh.
I had to sit there and just meditate on them three short verses, and that's why I'm sharing with you today. And it's just like the Lord has just directed it to that point. Some of you need rest. Just need rest. You've been carrying this load. By the way, that's why He gave us a church family.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Quit carrying everything by yourself. You don't have to do it.
Amen.
It's not a burden to ask your brothers and sisters in Christ to pray with you. It's a privilege.
Yeah.
Take it to the Lord in prayer. What a friend we have in Jesus.
Yeah.
And that old hymn I keep thinking about, and I was thinking about it this week when I started talking to the Lord again. I got to think about that old hymn. Just a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
Yeah.
Praise God. I can talk with Jesus when nobody else will listen.
Yeah.
Sometimes my cats get tired of me talking to them. They'll walk away. I'll keep talking to Jesus. Because I know that my cats can't fix my problems, and I know that certain things can't help, but I know Jesus Christ always that has and always will.
Amen. That's right.
Some of you are tired today. You're tired. You need to come. Bring it honestly to the Lord and bring it with us. Don't be ashamed. We've all been there. If we're not there right now. And let us pray for you, believing in Jesus' name that help is on the way.
Amen.
We don't know what that looks like or how it would be, but we're going to pray that God's intervening this very moment on your behalf, that He is dispatching a band of angels to bring you the answer you need to help you through whatever you're going through.
Amen.
I can't let that in.
that. I'm sorry, I ain't that educated. Our closing hymn today is hymn number 9, Glorify Thy Name. The altars are open. Of course, I have asked Marvin and Sherry to come up. We're going to be praying for them. And after we finish singing, and everyone that will, I will want to join. So we really need to join as a family on this one.
Amen.
I mean, this sounds like a Dateline exclusive almost. But you know what? God knows where that boy's at.
That's right. That's right.
Please stand.
A song of praise. We've come. come to you, gathered in this place, for the things you've done and for who you are. We worship you with a thankful heart.